sitting at the coffee table where you're reading Kierkegaard.
My dearest Jess, 5 years ago, I fell in love with you, and it was like getting hit by a truck. For 5 years, as we've laughed and cried and eaten, as we've gotten hit by the same truck over and over again, we've been building the foundation for the rest of our lives.
Well, baby, I never did.
Let's go get married.
Let's go get married.
This is it.
It was our second date when he told me that he wanted to marry me. And I thought that was kind of crazy, but I sort of was okay with it, I guess.
The second time that we were really on a date together, I told Jess that we would get married someday. And she laughed.
So darling, what do you say? Does that sound like a plan to you? We can build our own little world where no one else can come through.
I remember the moment we met so clearly, and I was in love with you by the end of our first date. So when you told me on our second that we would stand here together someday, I sort of knew you were right.
We can live in huts made out of grass. We can greet Father Time as he walks past. We can press our feet into the dirt. A little mud, no, it wouldn't hurt.
That is one handsome little boy.
And then from behind, you make a loop. Right. Now pull it up on the neck. And we can...
Thanks, fellas.
Now you can get married.
Just you and me.
He's just the person I'd always most like to be hanging out with. Like, whatever I'm doing, it's more fun if he's there.
So I see it seems we're settled down.
On this beautiful hillside, under a limitless sky, in front of our dear family and wonderful friends, I make these vows to you. I promise to always respect you. I promise to listen to you and to remain open. I promise to always trust you and to do my best to be deserving of your trust. I promise to have faith in us and always remember that we are on the same team. I promise to love you the best I can, as much as I can, for as long as I can. I make these vows today so you will always remember them. I love you.
I promise a home, a safe place where we make the rules and nothing matters more than our team. You're the best man I've ever met, and it's an honor to be your wife. I love you, and I promise I always will.
Cheers.
Cheers. I love you.
Love you too.
How short even last couple of years. So too have the years themselves. 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 The years themselves.
All the years
Did it help that John David was smart? Yes.
Did it help that he was handsome and charming and funny?
Sure.
Of course it did. But the beauty of the partnership that JD offered rested not in their similarities, but in their differences. JD challenged Jess fundamentally in ways that those of us who know and love her deeply would never dare.
I just love you completely. I love everything about you. And I can't wait to see what the rest of our lives has in store.
I'm glad that we've had all of those moments, and I'm hoping we get to steal a few more at the reception.